Hello, anyone and everyone. I'm Echo, and today we're exploring Firewatch. In the last episode, we came down here and found Brian Goodwin's little hideout place. I actually want to jump down here real quick, go back across. I'm not sure if we have to go all the way around back to the original entrance of the cave or not, but I do just want to climb up here real quick and see what's around. Okay, that's a long fall, and they're cracked rock. Drive Python into crack. Okay, so I think we are meant to go down this way, but just in case, I mean, I think it makes sense that we should probably be able to somehow climb back up the way we left the cave, right? No? No, okay, I guess not. I guess not. We could just literally walk up on this and use this like stairs and haul ourselves up onto it, but, you know, video game, limited mobility and all that. Oh, darn. Not possible. But that's okay, because we got the pythons, which are anchors for climbing down, and for some reason the game insists on calling them pythons instead of anchors, even though the characters called them anchors in dialogue, and anchors is
what do you think is in there?
Something in there? I don't know. What do you think? Probably gonna be killed. I don't know,
really. I mean, we gotta find out. What do you think?
Whatever it is, they don't want you telling anyone about.
They closed the door when they could have just
bashed your head in with a rock or chopped you up with a...
Are you serious with this shit right now?
A hatchet. God, are you sure you want to go back in there?
No. But we gotta figure out the mystery.
Honestly, I just want to know. I want to know what is worth doing everything that's been done to us.
Yeah, me too. And not going to jail would be a nice kicker.
Yeah, that too. Yeah, yeah. Sure. Yeah, not going to jail. It's pretty cool. But really, that mystery, though. We gotta figure it out.
Also, those girls turned up. Looks like you didn't kill them. Nobody did. They took some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and, landed in jail.
Serves them frickin' right. Wonder if they know anything? Damn it, phew. Phew, yeah.
Dodged a bullet there.
Yeah. We've got enough unanswered shit to answer for, I'd say.
Yeah, unanswered stuff is pretty bad. Especially when you're expected to answer for it. Okay. It's actually a completely different entrance than when we used last time, because that leads to two forks. We went the very, very long way around. Wonder if anyone's planning on closing the frickin' gate on us again. Hope not. Very much hope not. Though, actually, okay, I'm going to stop and theorize for a second here. The people who gave us the key, right now Henry and Delilah are assuming they gave him the key so that he would go in the cave, they could lock him in here, and then he'd basically go missing and starve to death, and then they could cover it up. What if possibly those people who gave him the key want him to, actually come down here and find out what they're hiding or something like that, or perhaps just lead him on, generally speaking, and maybe the reason they locked the gate is because they knew Henry would go in there, find the long drop, and then possibly turn around and walk back out the gate, thinking, oh, well, I can't go down there because I don't have anchors, and maybe they locked him in here so he'd be forced to go out and find the other exit, find Brian Goodwin's stuff, and find the anchors that Brian Goodwin left behind. Maybe that's their plan. I can't think of a reason why they would want to do that, but it's a possibility, and I want to keep all possibilities open. So let's drive that python in. That horribly named object that clips through the rock. Oh, it shrunk in size. That's a little weird. During the animation, the hole that the chain goes through is really big and thick. And yet, after it's in, it's not anymore. Okay. Sure, game. Sure. I'll buy it. Ooh. It's just getting spookier by the second. I wonder if we're... That's a bad idea. Possibly... Oh geez, I just thought... What if the people watching us for some reason want us to find Brian Goodwin's corpse? Maybe... Because we found that shoe earlier. In the last episode. While we were, partway through. We found the shoe that had landed on the rock. What if, Brian Goodwin fell down here and died? And those people want us to find his freaking body? Holy crap. Maybe that's what they trapped me in here for. Okay, that's a way to go. Can we actually go down this way? No, okay. Just had to double check. That would be real bad. Extra supreme bad with sour cream on top. God, I'm hungry for a burrito. It's been a long time since I've eaten a good burrito. I know this probably isn't the time and place to be reminiscing about burritos, but I'm actually really hungry. Holy crap.
Oh, shit.
Whew. Called it! Is that seriously... Broken climbing gear.
Your stuff gave out. Oh, poor fucking...
Single missing shoe.
You're Brian Goodwin. Oh no. God. Poor kid.
Crypto, castle, collectibles, and comics. Oh my god. Oh, that's nasty. His socks are rotting and they fused with his body. I think. Sort of what it looks like. Oh, jeez. Yeah, that's definitely gotta be Brian Goodwin's body. The shoe... The missing shoe doesn't tie it to Brian Goodwin, but the missing shoe does tie it to the earlier theory I had. The thing... We know Brian Goodwin likes, wizards and wyverns, as they call it in this game, so it would make sense that he would have a shirt of a collectibles and comics store that he probably frequents, and kids aren't supposed to be out here. He's the only kid we know of that would have been out here anytime recently, and also, even if other kids were out here, how many of them would be adventurous enough, like Brian Goodwin, to, bring out their own climbing gear and try to get down here. But then again, Brian Goodwin he hated climbing. He tried hiding the anchors so that he wouldn't have to go climbing with his dad, so why would he willingly climb down here? Okay, and there's also the fact that the game is clearly labeling it Brian Goodwin's body, so perhaps we're supposed to not be analyzing it like this and just shut up and accept it. This is Brian Goodwin. But I'm not gonna just completely rule out the possibility that maybe it's a fake body planted by the people who tried to trap Henry down here. I'm not gonna rule out any possibility right now, because this is getting... God, this is crazy, but I love it. I love it, it's so good. Oh my god. Appropriate reaction from Henry, by the way. Very glad. It's all too common in video games for a character to witness another character's death, or perhaps just find their dead body, and their reaction is completely unrealistic. Either they're super overly emotional for a character they barely knew at all, or they, barely react in the slightest for someone they did know. Both of those are surprisingly, disturbingly common. Almost as if the people who write for them don't know how human emotions work. Like, I don't know what's going on, but yeah. Reactions to death in video games are very often inaccurate, and I think Henry had a very, very good one. Again, gotta point out how, like, great the writing in this game is. It's just... oh, it's awesome. So good. So good. Anyway. Still going on. Still haven't found anything like what we expected. Henry and Delilah were expecting to find, like, you know, futuristic space technology stuff from the people who have been watching us, you know, like a secret base or something, or laboratory or whatever. But I'm getting the feeling none of that's down here. I'm getting the feeling the only thing down here is Brian Goodwin. Supposed Brian Goodwin. Most likely Brian Goodwin. I do believe, right now, I do believe it's most likely Brian Goodwin for real. But, like I said, not going to rule out the possibility that it's a fake or someone else. You know. Also, very nice bit of backtracking, looping around bit there. Didn't even notice this when I walked in. Didn't notice it at all, and we ended up going in one big circle. I really like that. That is good, tight level design. Very good. Alright, let's go back up here, back up to Two Forks. Unless it's on fire now. I don't know, there's enough smoke around. Could be fires all over.
Hey, D.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
Sit down.
Hey, you, might want to take a seat.
I've been sitting this entire time. I'm almost always sitting. What's wrong?
The only thing in the cave was a body.
A body? God, what a mess.
Delilah. It's Brian Goodwin.
Gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... what? I don't... how?
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident.
Mm-hmm.
Why would it be Ned? That's a complete shot in the dark.
I think that's just what it was. I mean, he was probably exploring the cave and maybe his rope gave out. But whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him.
Oh no, unless it was a warning. Oh geez.
What do we do now, Dee? I mean, are you okay?
No. I'm not. He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave. There's nothing to say. Hike back. I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway.
Oh, but yeah, no, I just had the idea. What if that was like a warning? What if the people following us did kill him and make it look like a climbing accident, and they wanted us to find his body to get us to stop? Oh my god. And why are we leaving already? Is summer already over? What? How could that be? What? No, the game can't be over that fast. I don't know, but there's a plane going by. Oh man, there's gonna be some...
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
Well, is this the Flapjack fire, or the site fire, or...?
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec, you know, about things?
About what?
Yeah, everything.
About how all this stuff is connected. The surveillance, the Goodwins, Brian's death.
Look, I don't know what to say, okay? It's like the universe cooked up the cruelest thing to have happen. Does it connect to everything else? I don't know. I don't know if I even want to.
Of course you do. There's gotta be a reason.
Was there?
Maybe. Maybe not. I wouldn't even know where to begin.
Well, fuck. For starters, I guess you could find the source of that signal.
Holy crap. Yeah, oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us, whoever made the tape.
Okay, yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
Alright, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
I was hoping you'd have a plan.
I was hoping you'd have a backup plan or something.
Yeah, okay, I'm probably gonna move to Canada. Ontario, maybe.
No, I meant if something happens to me.
Right, if you don't find out who made the tape and I have to hit the road.
Forget it.
Be safe, Henry.
Huh. Wow. Cassette tape. Can't remember. Oh, that was the, that was the cassette tape they, that was in the cassette player they gave us with the voices on it and everything. And, yeah, honestly, the beeping, as soon as I noticed it, it sort of scared me a little. Jeez. I don't know if we're actually supposed to, like, I don't see any, button prompts to actually put any of this stuff away and pack it up. So, I have to assume we're not actually supposed to do that. And I'll just get a move on. Also, she said after the two fires formed, they apparently named it after her lookout. Does that mean me? They named it the Henry Fire? That's freaking messed up. Hey, whoa. Where's the map? Thank you. I pressed M, game. I did not press V. I want the map out just in case. Okay. Oh my god, I can't see anything. So much dust. I mean, occasionally it blows away a bit. It's to the west. I want to see it real quick. Oh, it's probably the medicine wheel, I'm guessing? Or around cache 306. Something like that. I think we're going more towards cache 306, actually. Now that I think about it. Yeah, there's kind of... going actually straight west takes us into the big rock wall. So, we can't go directly towards where the signal is. Not too directly, at least. Okay. This is tense and frankly scary. Like, not scream my head off scary. Not that I ever would do that. I've got too much pride. But, you know. It's just a tense moment. Making me a little nervous. Okay, it's like straight ahead now. What's Henry's plan? Their only guess. Henry and Delilah's only guess.
What's your status?
Oh, jeez. Put the thing away. Quick.
I think I'm getting close.
Alright, well, I just got word that they are coming to get us. My place.
You sound worried.
No, it's just...
Brian?
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cutback in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
Okay. That it? Okay. Alright, I guess that's all she had to say. Right? Right. Alrighty. But yeah, no, seriously, what is... I think... I can't even tell where I am, to be honest. With all the dust around, I don't recognize the environment. and yeah. But yeah, no, like, what is, what's Henry's plan, you know? What's Delilah's plan for, following this signal? Their guess about what the signal was maybe it's the people who've been following us. Maybe they're hiding out there, and we picked up a signal of something they're holding on to. So what, is he gonna go find the people and spook them? Beat them up? Like, what's he gonna do? I don't know, but... okay, we just got past Cripple Gulch. Seems that the signal's coming from, like, right around the corner. Super close. Oh my god. This is actually really nerve-wracking. And I know I said that already. Apologies for, just, like, melting here in nervousness. Henry. What?
Someone left a rope for me to climb up. I'm down near the lake.
How do you know it's for you?
There's a tracking collar tied to it. Someone was leading me here. And there's another tape.
Oh my god, Henry.
I don't want to take the collar. I don't want a collar. Jeez. Take the cassette tape, though.
Yeah, hi, Henry. Hey, you better find this before it burns up. We've been causing each other a lot of headaches. Now I gotta go stake out a site that's as fit for living as the one you're about to find. You'll get it when you see it. You can't blame me for keeping an eye on you. Not after bumping into you back in May. Down by the cave, for croc's sake. I've been up here for 3 years. I kept it cozy. Winters are harsh as hell, and I ran out of books. But I got that antenna rigged up, and Delilah, she's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shithouse with you two. You guys don't know anything about having kids. All right, nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
Holy crap, what?
We found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
Ned Goodwin? He made the tape?
Yeah. He's gone. Deeper into the Shoshone. He doesn't want anyone to know he's out here.
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son. You need to get back here. They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Okay.
Hike north to Thoroughfare Lookout for evacuation. Holy crap. Well, I'll say I didn't expect that. So, Ned was teaching Brian to... Oh, so this is where he's been?
I guess he's been dumping trash up here for a while.
Improvised hatch. Wait a minute. Oh, we can't actually walk past this, so we have to go down into it.
There's a clothesline.
Yeah. We are meant to see this. Yeesh. He did well for himself, I guess.
He held on to some of Brian's things. His wizards and wyverns.
Yeah, well, I'm sure he found it riveting.
A role-playing rulebook. Father's Day card.
He... God.
What?
Nothing, just some of Brian's stuff.
To a rad, bad, mega dad. Huh.
Brian was a nice-looking kid.
Yeah.
I guess. Nice-looking. Can't really tell what someone's personality is like from their picture. Pfft. Not actually a big deal. Whatever. List of supplies. Winter needs. 1989. Lots of stuff. Okay. Wait, what's it say at the bottom? Summer weight gain goal. Try elk skin. Oh, he was actually losing weight by being out here. Yeah, I suppose he didn't have food delivered to him.
Goodwin was the one who wrote the reports I found at the site.
Observational traits. Oh, so he just, like, he faked them to make us think there was a government thing going on to try and scare us into leaving it all alone. Where'd he get all the, like, computer technology future stuff from?
He wrote down everything he did to us. And everything he did every day. He was scared shitless.
I bet.
Research site info. How to break in. Exit south lake gate. Loose entrance. North fence. Wapiti station. Oh, yeah, that's the entire thing. Okay. Staff return August 10th. To do, return borrowed equipment. Erase H plus D evidence. Leave no trace. So, was this all just... I guess this was all just technology that he borrowed from, like, biologists that were out here. And he just set it up to make it look like... Hey, he stole the teen's sleeping bag. That's cool. Serves him right. Stupid teenagers. Grumble, grumble. Old man noises. Workbench.
You should see some of the stuff he was working on. I guess he had a lot of time on his hands.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to say. I don't know what you want me to say. We're in the middle of a fire that is at 22,000 acres and growing. Fast.
It's gonna burn all of this up.
Well, take a picture if you're so keen to remember it.
You're not?
I don't know.
Actually, good idea. Just take a picture of all the stuff real quick. For evidence. Can't zoom in. Or if I can, I don't remember how. Yeah, I'm not big on taking style pictures, but I'll sure as hell take evidence. We'll leave that for last. Let's report this first.
This boombox looks familiar.
From the girls.
Yeah.
Oh, that's perfect.
He was rigging up stolen batteries to keep his stuff going.
Well, he was... what's the word? Resourceful. That's a compliment. I'll take another picture of all of this. I don't think the pictures are actually going to matter. But, you know, in case... Goodwin's view.
He had quite the view.
Okay, anything else? Ooh. Radio base? Report. Yeah, radio base station? That's a weird thing to call it.
He's got a radio base station up here. He was listening to us on that.
Yeah, by simply tuning in to the correct radio stations, you doofuses. Radio log. Yep, everything we said. Fucked up, did not want to leave. Reminder, hide supplies for migration. Blah, 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 observe, be ready to leave. Start working on reports, record all comms. Vandalize D's tower. Pin on 2 floor. Try to make remote recording device. Unit research site, move, pit against each other. Yeah. This dude had a plan. And it almost worked. But that's crazy, though. Like, jeez. I guess maybe this is kind of just a guess, like I said, but I suppose the guilt of his son dying, he didn't murder his son, but his son definitely died because of him, you know, in a way to describe it, because he kept making Brian go climbing and everything. I guess the guilt sort of made him a bit crazy. And, oh, he can see both towers. Kind of ironic that he chose a spot that could see exactly those two towers. But anyway, yeah, and I guess he got a bit crazy and he didn't want to be framed for murder, obviously. Or not framed. Didn't want to be suspected of murder, so he just stayed out here and let everybody think he disappeared.
He could see my lookout.
And yours.
Yours too.
Yep. Wow, holy crap. That's a good twist. That's kind of more satisfying than it being the obvious thing of some weird... You still can't go past? No? Okay, I guess we just gotta go back the way we came. But yeah, that's kind of... I think I do like that a little bit better than it being the obvious answer of weird government experiment going on. I have heard a lot of people complain that the ending to the game is disappointing. I don't know if I agree with that. That's not what I meant to say. I don't agree with that. But I understand why people would say that, because I guess the whole government conspiracy thing is probably more exciting. But I don't think it necessarily makes for the best story, because it's just so obvious, you know? But I don't know, the game's not even over yet, so I'm gonna withhold final judgment until the credits are rolling. Also, I have a feeling this episode's gonna be very long, because I think we're, like, literally right at the end of the game, and I'm not about to, not about to stop the video here, and then do a 10-minute video after this of mostly watching the credits go by and whatever, like, final cutscene we see. Yeah, we gotta go, right, hike north to Thoroughfare Lookout for evacuation. Right where we were before. So, we just got past Cripple Gulch. So, basically go straight east. Can't sprint while the map is out, unfortunately. Basically, we wanna go straight east and then up north after,
I know I should be relieved. Relieved that there's no evidence of us starting that fire. Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. He was a sweet kid. With a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
Yeah.
He wasn't a good dad.
No fucking shit. But what? It would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home. I can't stop thinking about it.
Don't blame yourself, it'll be okay. Yeah, but you didn't. It's not really your fault.
You didn't do anything wrong.
Yes, I did.
Actually, she didn't break the law.
I've got to decide whether I tell people that he's down there so they can retrieve the body or not. And if I do, I'm going to be asked about Ned Goodwin.
Dee?
Oh, fuck.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on. Hey! No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming. Okay, 1 second. Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
Whoa. No. Wait.
Wait, just wait, okay? I'm not that far.
Henry, they're here. They're waiting right now.
Please.
Henry, I don't want to meet you and just sit here in a dead boy's shadow. Okay, I don't want to do that. I know that sounds harsh. Okay, I'll wait.
Get damn better.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm, you know, super sorry for you that you're depressed and you feel guilty. Feel partially responsible for the kid's death. That's great. That's fine. You have every right to be sad, but, don't go, thinking you can leave me behind. And I guess I'm taking the long way around, because I couldn't, unfortunately, with all the dust and everything around, and with me being relatively rusty at finding, you know, the paths and everything with the map, just because, for the beginning of the game, you kind of have to find your own way around, but it seems for the second half of the game, you're mostly backtracking to areas you've already been, so you spend less time looking at the map and comparing it to your compass, and more time just, you know, sort of following the paths that you're familiar with. So, a little bit rusty on that, and combined with the very poor visibility, I'm, right, I have to go through the cave. Okay, right. Yeah, combined with the poor visibility, I could not find the way through the bushes. So, gonna have to go the long way around through the canyon. Not my preferred way of, my preferred method of doing it. But, if it works, if it works indeed. Let me just, double check the map real quick. Make sure I'm going the right way. Kind of going more east here, but of course it does wrap around a lot. So it's inevitable that at some points I'll be going east. As long as I keep going that way. I can even see, yeah, it even shows like her tower and the power lines. Please don't stop sprinting, Henry. Yeah, we should be able to make our way up there without too much problem. It's gonna be an interesting ending. Is it actually gonna, because so far it hasn't shown any, like, character models. You know, we only see Henry from a first-person view. And it always shows, like, hand-drawn pictures when we've seen people's, like, faces. Yep, going the right way. So I wonder if, for the end cutscene, getting in the helicopter and all that, I wonder if it's actually going to show, like, the pilot or Delilah, or if it's just going to sort of cut off, perhaps? Or maybe even though she promised to, shoot. I'm at cache 302. Need to go this way. Or maybe even though she promised to wait, maybe we'll get close and she'll suddenly change her mind and leave us behind. Maybe convincing her to wait isn't actually a choice within our power. Come on, Henry. Pick up the pace, buddy. go all the way up here. Again, sort of backtracking on a path that we already took at one point. Oh, not there. Up more. Up more somewhere? Wait. Stupid rocks. Getting trapped. No, that's the... Isn't it? Do I have to go up even more to get the other path? Yes, I do. Okay. Yeesh. That was a bit disorienting. I kept my memories with what I was... weren't matching up with what I was seeing. That's okay, though. Oh boy, 40-minute long episode. That's great. That's fantastic. Where are we? I mean, not where are we. I know where we are. I just hope we're still, yeah, that's the second path down, so... Okay. Should be good. This way. Yes. Okay. Now I remember exactly where we are. The supply drop is up on the left. And, hook... railway system thingy should be right up here. And we can see her tower. Beautiful. Beautiful. Kind of a shame they didn't talk more during the thing.
Hey, I'm at the evac spot near the ravine. Delilah, are you there? Delilah?
Gonna hope she just abandoned her radio to get in the helicopter and wait for him. Hopefully. What's the word? I swear to God, unless I'm crazy, I thought I saw words appearing above the cursor. Like, right at about this spot? I'm not sure. Oh well. Delilah's Tower.
Oh, God, it's a nightmare out there. Hello? Delilah!
Of course. God damn it.
Damn it.
Hey, Teddy Roosevelt. Maps of the area. Ocean's Gambit, desk lamp, blah, blah, blah. Radio headset? That's probably what we need to pick up. Henry. What we know. White shorts. Drawing by Delilah. Yeah. Is he gonna say anything? I suppose? No? Okay. Kind of a shame. Thought he would, thought he'd have a comment on it, since we obviously can't talk to Delilah. Thought maybe he would do something, but oh well. Okay, radio headset.
Hello? Is anybody there?
Hi. Yeah, it's me.
You're not here.
No. Don't be mad.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not mad. I'm just...
You're not mad? You're just disappointed?
I'm not your dad after you got busted smoking pot.
I just couldn't be out there for another minute.
Well, you could have just said that.
You really wanted me to stay.
I did. And now I'm...
disappointed.
Yeah.
I know. Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Ah, shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
Oh, I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me, and I'll choose for you.
All right, sure. Maybe...
She stole one of the signs, too! She stole one of the pork pond signs! That's why she... Come to Boulder with me. Move to Santa Fe. Become crossword editor at the New York Times. No. We've got a wife.
Maybe move to Santa Fe. Open a jade emporium with your sister.
I'd be trading cute ski bombs for yoga retreat hippies, but maybe that's not all bad.
What's the margarita situation?
I mean, yeah.
So what about me?
I think you should go to Julia, and then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
Yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Yeah. Yeah. No two ways about it.
Yeah. Sure.
Henry, look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
You're right. I mean, I think you're right.
Good.
When I get back, maybe I could,
We shouldn't focus on this summer. Next year we'll roll around, and then the year after that, and then it's just a... I don't know. My Aunt Judy called it a pause in the hallway of time.
Did your Aunt Judy smoke a lot of pot?
Yeah?
Well, you should try to take her advice, too.
Yeah, we'll see.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
Thanks. You too. See you when I see ya. You too.
You too. Good luck.
No. Henry, you keep it for yourself, okay? Bye, Hank.
Knew it. I knew they wouldn't show any character models. This isn't that kind of game. Also, super long episode. Whoops. Probably could have split this up into a second one. But I just kept going. Oh well. Watch as we get close to the helicopter, then a guy pops out and shoots us as he goes to shake our hand. Come on, you won't let me sprint during this part. Is it so important that I walk slowly up to the helicopter? Hey! It has no face. Get me out of here, buddy. Yes, that was a video game by Campo Santo. Okay. Oh, produced in cooperation with Panic. Yep. We know all this. We saw the credits at the beginning. So, well, I'll try to stick around in case they show a scene at the end. I don't think they would. That's not really common with video games, but I guess it's possible. So, yeah. I'm not going to... I don't think the ending was bad. I think people overreacted when they were like, oh no, it's so disappointing and bad and... ugh. Oh, is it showing all the pictures we took? It is. It's showing the actual pictures that we took off the camera. All the evidence pictures. So... okay, yeah, I guess those didn't really matter. I guess I could have just been taking pretty pictures the whole time instead of those. But oh well, anyway, point is, yeah, no, I don't think the ending was bad. I think it maybe could have had more of a twist and been a bit more exciting. You know, I do understand the people who say they didn't like it because it was, you know, disappointing or whatever, but I think it matched the situation well. And like I said earlier, I think the having it be a government conspiracy would have just been too obvious and a bit weird. That was just the one test picture I took. Oh, hey! Oh, Henry's face. That's right, he accidentally took a picture of himself and almost blinded himself with the flash when he first found the camera. Interesting. Oh. Oh, these are pictures that were already on the roll of film that Brian took. And that must be Ned. And Brian, of course. Dang. That's a good trick, though. Putting in the pictures that Brian took at the end there, that gives it like a sad touch at the end. I like that. It's good. Pretty good. You did good, Campo Santo. Congratulations, you get my seal of approval. I don't really have any more words to say about it. I already said it as I was playing the game. You know, I like the story. I like the game. I think it was great. I think it was immersive, and the story was good. I think the ending was sufficient. I honestly can't think up any better words to describe the ending. It wasn't the best, but it wasn't bad. Also, now that we're at the menu, I would like to point out something that I only just now noticed. That's actually not the Two Forks Tower. I never actually, like, even paid enough attention to notice if it was the Two Forks Tower or not. I just kind of assumed it was, because that's the one our character stays in. That's actually Delilah's Tower. That's the same, like, stairway and the rocks and everything that it was on that when we went to visit a second ago. So, yeah. Anyway. Yeah, great game. If any of you liked it and, you know, think it's worth another playthrough, maybe you can find things that I missed. Or maybe, maybe you can just want to, soak in the atmosphere, walk through the woods, and adventure around even more than I did. Then feel free to, buy the game yourself. Give it a shot. Link in the description, as always. Just want to, point that out to help, support indie developers as little as I can. Because I think they need the help sometimes. But anyway, yeah. Good game. See y'all next time in whatever game I play next. Don't know what it's going to be. Buh-bye.